Yes, I'm policy officer in the city of Copenhagen, so I work for the Lord Mayor's department. And the Lord Mayor is like the overall mayor of the city of Copenhagen. So he I'm responsible together with some other people for his green policies. So we have a small department called Green Growth, and it's situated in the Department of Urban Planning, where you have all these policies of developing the city. I think one of the major achievements for Copenhagen is that we're really pursuing a green energy strategy. So we are building windmills in the city, and we are having our power plants firing on biomass. And we are also expanding the area of district cooling, so that you use the seawater to cool houses. So this is also very energy efficient. So I think that's one of our main achievements. I think the citizens in Copenhagen are overall very supportive of green policies, because they see that it improves their life quality. So for example, in Copenhagen, you have many green areas, and people really like this. And also in Copenhagen, we have cleaned the seawater. Copenhagen is placed by the sea. And we have cleaned the seawater around the city so that you can actually, in the summer, you can swim in the city. And this is also something, of course, the citizens enjoy a lot. And they like that they can go around by bike everywhere, so that this is also something that they really support. But of course, then when you have large construction projects, then people don't want to live close to them. So for example, we are expanding our metro to have more green public transport. And this is, of course, unpopular if people are living very close to the working stations where the metro will be built now for 7 years, and they will have a lot of noise and a lot of trucks going in and out. For example, building windmills inside a city. You can imagine that nobody wants maybe to be neighbor to a windmill, and you don't want the windmill to be able to hurt anybody if a wing falls off. So this is a difficulty that we wanted. At first, we wanted to put windmills in many different places. But then when you examine the places, you say, oh, this is too close to this working place, or too close to the residential homes there. So now we have only a few spots left that are available for windmills. I think overall the city just pursues a very active information policy, so that you have many open meetings where you meet with the public and you tell them about the plans that you're planning, and they can ask questions. You have what you call public hearings. So we, as a city, we propose, like we say, we're going to do this and that, and we describe it in a document. And then every citizen, they can send us their responses and say, oh, we don't like this, so we suggest that you change this in this and that direction. So in that sense, I think it's a very open process. And of course, our city council politicians, also the Lord Mayor, they take time to have many meetings with the citizens and explain their policies and talk with the citizens. So I think this is how you try to engage everybody. I think it was very interesting to hear some of the other cities, what they're doing. And I think, for example, now we're talking about citizens' engagement. I think many cities had some good input on how they engage their local community. So I think that was very helpful. Oh, I also thought it was very interesting, for example, the city of Portland, that showed how it's economically beneficial to actually make green investments. I thought that was very interesting also. And then, of course, it was very nice just to experience also Taipei County and the great hospitality of Taiwan.
So I think the key challenge for many cities is to achieve an environmental as well as financial balance when working towards sustainable growth in the city. In Copenhagen, we believe that the key to meeting this challenge is green growth. Climate solutions and green technology will be some of the decisive competitive parameters of the future. In Copenhagen, we are aiming to become the world's first carbon neutral capital. This is, of course, a very ambitious political agreement. Today, 97% of Copenhageners are connected to the district heating system. This is a very high share. As you know, district heating is a very energy efficient system, but we want to also make it a green energy system. What we have done then is work with our central power plants to convince them to convert to biomass. One central power plant has already converted, and a second power plant will convert this year. These conversions are financed by the energy producers, and are in this way also demonstrating our ideas of partnerships between the city and the industry. Another area where we are pursuing green energy is in Green District Cooling. We have one full-scale cooling plant in operation in Copenhagen, and a second plant will open next year. Already now they save the city 14,000 tons of CO2 emissions every year. The city of Copenhagen also wants to pursue the energy of geothermal power. We have already now a small demonstration plant working in the city, and a full-scale power plant will be built in the North Harbour in the coming years. Our project for green energy, of course, also entails windmills. As you may know, Denmark has a very strong record on windmills, and in Copenhagen also we already have windmills at the border of the city. We want windmills to be an integrated part of the Copenhagen skyline. As you can see from the picture, we already have windmills, but we want to expand this both inside and outside the city. The city of Copenhagen is planning to engage in offshore projects in the sea just surrounding Copenhagen. For us, it's very important to secure the engagement of the public in buying these windmills and in raising these windmills. As you know, it can be a challenge to raise windmills in an urban environment where people don't want to live too close to the windmill due to noise, or maybe it's dangerous if the wind falls off. So it's very important for us all the time to keep the public engagement by encouraging citizens to take part in the windmills. It's possible today to buy shares of the windmills, and it is also developing a program where the citizens should be able to buy green electricity from the windmills. Thank you.